Welcome to Naresh Technologies. I'm Bangaraju, and in this video, I wanted to demonstrate to you about indexers. So what are these indexers? Indexer is a member of a class, and if you define this indexer in a class, your class starts behaving like a virtual array. So it is a member which gives access to values of a class just like an array, and your class starts behaving like an array, not an array, virtual array. So what I mean to tell you is, suppose you have a class representing one entity called as employee, and under this you are just going to have some attributes of the employee, like employee number, employee name, job of the employee, salary of the employee, okay. Still the department name of the employee, in which department is going to work for, the location of this department. Like this, we are just going to have some attributes associated with the employee. If you're going to have some attributes associated with the employee, I want to access these attributes now. Means first let us define a class representing an employee. It will be more clear for us to understand. I've taken a project with a class called employee, a public class. In this, I wanted to declare some variables representing the attributes of employee. Representing the attributes of employee, let us declare some variables now. So, six attributes, okay. First, int e number. Second, string e name, job d name, and location. Okay, next, double salary. These are six attributes of the employee. Six attributes of the employee, and I want to initialize them. I wanted to initialize them. How? Public employee, and defining with a constructor, a parameterized constructor for initializing all these attributes. Int e number, string e name, string job, double salary, string dname, string location. So constructor with six attributes. So what you will write right here? This dot e number is equals to e number, this dot e name is equals to e name, this dot job equals to job, this dot salary is equals to salary, this dot d name is equals to d name, and this dot location is equals to location. So like this, you defined a class with six attributes. Now all the six attributes are defined inside the class. And now you notice this. This is my class with all the six attributes. See, can I consume this class from another class or another project? Yeah. Basically, once we define the class, means you can consume the class wherever you want now. So to consume this class, what am I doing now? Add a new class. I'll call this class as test employee, static void main, employee emp is equals to new employee. Now passing all the values, employee number 1001, employee name some Scott, job manager, some salary 20,000, department name some sales, and location is Mumbai. All the attributes have been passed now, and the instance is created. And remember, whenever you create the instance internally, the constructor of the class calls, and all these variables are initialized. Actually today we passed all these values manually on our own, but tomorrow when you work in the real-time environment, You don't pass all these values, you pass only one value. What is the value? Employee number. Once I pass employee number, in this class, the code will be like reading all the remaining values from the database. So if you send an employee number, automatically the rest of the data will be loaded from the database. Okay, fine. So if you pass employee number, this data will be already in the database. From the database, we'll load name, job, salary, dename and location. Here, I am not dealing with the database here. Simple, that's why I pass some static values. So here, when I create the instance, constructor is called and the memory is allocated and all the variables are initialized. If this is the instance of your class, okay, what is the name we have given? EMP is the instance name. EMP is the instance name. Okay, now under this, all the six attributes are going to be initialized. All the six. So internally, all the six variables will be initialized. Okay, so what are those variables? Let us assume like this is E number, E name, job, salary, and lastly here we have dename and location. All are initialized with the corresponding values. So what are the values we passed here? 1001 1001. The name we passed is Scott and job manager, salary some 20,000, sales and location some Mumbai. Things are initialized. So once we create the instance, the memory is allocated and all the variables are initialized. Okay, but still, where we created the instance in the test employee, and EMP is an instance of the class create under test employee, but using this EMP, we cannot access any attribute. EMP dot is not showing you any attribute in the list first. Not showing is not accessing. Why not accessing? Because the default scope for the members of a class in C sharp language is private. If you are not clear about it, please watch the video of access specifiers in C sharp to be more clear about it. Earlier I posted a video called access specifiers in C sharp. Have a look on that. So here, if you just notice it, default scope for the members of a class in C sharp is private. So all the six variables what are declared here are private, so they are not accessible outside. So if you want to access them outside, the first mechanism means three different options are there for accessing outside. Option number one, declare all the six variables as public. But if you declare them as public, out of the class anyone can get, anyone can set the values. As a developer, you don't have any control on that particular value. Means if you make public, everyone can access that particular value. It is not a right idea to declare variables of a class as public. That's a very bad idea. Okay, never do it. So if, because you will lose control on that. Second option. The second option what we have is properties. What is it? Declare the variables and define some properties on the variables. And once you define the properties on the variables, using the properties, we can start accessing the values. See, like if you go with the property, what is an advantage is restricted access to the value, only get access, only set access, or both get set access. Like this, you can give any type of access to the appropriate value, get access or set access or get set access. But if at all you just go with a public variable, every value will have get set access. Anyone can get, anyone can set. But a property means not get set access. What is it? Either get or either set or both get set. That depends. Requirement based we can give. That is one option. Third option, indexer. What is the indexer? Indexer is also something like a property, but provides access to the values using the index positions. So what exactly I mean to tell you is, I want to access all the six values from test employee. But see, EMP dot, it's not giving an access. But if EMP is an array, how do you access the value EMP of 0? That's how we generally access the values, if it is an array. But right now, if you understand, EMP of 0 is an error. I'm getting an error here. Why are you getting an error? Because you cannot apply indexing on a class directly. If you read the error message, cannot apply indexing with square braces to an expression of type employee. It's not possible. You cannot apply this. Why can't we apply? Because see, indexing cannot be done at all on a class. We can do it on an array, but we cannot do on a new class like an employee. You have a defined class. We cannot apply this. It can be applied on array. Array is a predefined class and all the logic is written into it. But employee is not a predefined class. You have a defined class. But if I give you that style of access, now you can access all the six values by using 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Just like an array. If you want that style of access, if you want that style of access, you need to define an indexer in the class. Once you define an indexer in the class, you can start accessing values of the class by using the index positions. So how to define an indexer? Watch. Modifiers, type this int index, get statements, we call this as a get accessor, set statements, we call it as a set accessor, get accessor, set accessor. So what you're going to do right now is simply a modifier type this means modifier public or what you want, and what type of value are you going to provide the access. So actually I want to access the values like this, means if I say console dot write line emp of 0, it has to print me the employee number, but I'll write like this. E name, job, salary, D name, location, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So notice it, I want to print all the values like this, but right now if I try, I'll get an error. 6 errors, not like one error, 6 errors comes to picture. Why? It'll tell you, cannot apply indexing with square braces to an expression of type employee. Not possible. But I want to use it. If you want to apply, what you require to do is go to the employee class, and in this class we need to define this indexer. Okay, how to define the indexer? Watch it. This is the syntax. Modifiers. I am writing the modifier as public. Type. Now it is asking what type of value are you expecting. Suppose if I say EMP of 0, what I want? Employee number. EMP of 0 means what I am expecting? Number, integer. EMP of 1. String, EMP of 2, string, EMP of 3, double, EMP of 4, string, EMP of 5, string. Means three different types of values you are expecting, integer, double, string. So what you will write here, you know, object. Why object? If it is object, it can return any type of value. That is why we use object. Afterwards, we use this. What is the this? This is to tell we are defining an indexer on the current class. Indexer is defined on the current class, so that what is going to happen is the instance of that class only will start providing the access to the values. Means indexer is defined on the class. That is the meaning of the statement. Afterwards, int index. This is how we should start with. Okay. And now get set. What is get? Get is for returning the values. Set is for assigning the values. Means see, out of the class, what you want to do? You want to access the value or assign the value also. Tomorrow, you want to know what is the employee number, or tomorrow you want to change the employee number. You want to get, you want to set. Two things you are trying to do. So, get logic has to be implemented to get the values outside the class. Set has to be implemented so that the values will come in if you assign a value out of the class. Okay, not within the class, out of the class. So within the class, variable is directly accessible to you. It is all about out of the class. Out of the class, these six variables are not accessible. So we are providing access through the indexer. So first, let us write get. Get. This is called get accessor. Some statements here. What are the statements? Very simple code here. Suppose if the user asks EMP of 0. EMP of 0. What should I give him? Employee number. So if index is equals to 0, what you will write, you know, return E number. That's it here. That's only what you're required to do. Means when you're trying to call EMP of 0, in this place, what has to come now? E number has to come. And have you noticed it? See, right now still code is not completed, but see, no errors here. Earlier, all these are showing errors, but right now there are no errors coming into picture here. Okay, next, else if index is equals to 1, what to do? Return ename. Else if index equals to 2, return job. Else if index is equals to 3, return salary. Else if index is equals to 4, return dname. Else if index is equals to 5, return location. Return location, all the 6. Don't write else, write else if. The reason why I'm telling not write else is, if you write else, what is the problem, you know? You're expecting else means last value. But tomorrow if I say EMP of 10, EMP of 10 will come to else part and returns the location. So don't do that. Always go for else if. In the last you say return null. When this logic will execute, suppose if the user is giving 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 values will come. Apart from that you give anything, null will come. So that's why we are doing this return null. So this is a get accessor. This is the code. So get accessor is defined for returning a value. Get accessor is defined for returning a value. Okay, now come to test employee start. All the 6 values. You can see now. So are we able to access the values from the test employee class? Yes. How? By using the index positions. So once you define an indexer under a class, immediately the class starts working like a virtual array. It starts working like a virtual array. Okay. Well, now understand. Here, EMP of 0, 1, 2, 3 means index format we followed. If you feel you are confused with a zero based index, is our code, our choice. I can do my own things here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Come back. So without confusion, first value, second value, third value, 4, 5. I generally notice so many people confusing with the index because count, index, these are always different. Index will be 1 less than the count. Count will be 1 more than the index. So without that, if you start index from 1, count and index will be same now. So no difference. So this is how you are just going to define an indexer in your class. But remember, this indexer is used only for getting the values. You cannot set the values. Means you can access but cannot assign. See, if you have an array with a size of 5, array name is ARR. ARR of 0 will give access to the value. And you can assign a value also. ARR of 0 is equals to, you can assign a value. You can capture it, you can assign. But this indexer is defined only for capturing, not for assigning. If you try assigning, you will get an error. Watch. I want to change the job of the employee. Job means third value. EMP of 3 is equals to. I want to make the job as senior manager. But when I try this, I get an error. What is the error? It is telling you indexer employee dot this of int cannot be assigned to, it is read only. You cannot assign, it is telling. Why you cannot assign? Because we have implemented only get accessor. Get accessor will only get the value. If you implement set accessor, then assignment will be working. So we implemented only get accessor. Get accessor is for getting the value. If you implement the set accessor, then assignment also works. If you want to assign, compulsory you are required to go for implementing the set accessor. See, right now failed. Shall we implement the set accessor now? Come on. Just like get, now you are required to write set. Some logic. What is the logic you are going to implement here is, the user is trying to assign a value, EMP of 3. Tomorrow the user may try to assign a value, EMP of 1 is equals to 1002. The user may want to assign a value like this, EMP of 1 is equals to 1002. If at all you define EMP of 1 is equals to 1002, the value should be assigned to employee number. Okay, if you say 2 is equals to something, value should be assigned to name. If 3 is equals to, value to be assigned to job. Like this, based on this index, assignment should change to the appropriate variable in the class. So just like we used index and return, how do you write the logic? You know, if index is equals to 1. If index is equals to 1 means you are assigning a value to what? Employee number. The value should come to E number now. How do you write the logic? You know, E number is equals to value. What is this value? What is this value is? Value is one implicit variable that provides access to the value assigned by the user. Whatever value the user assigns, see, user assigns a value 1002, and this value you can access in your code with a parameter called as value, but we did not declare anywhere, no need. There is a specialty here, no need to declare anywhere, it is implicit. Because it is implicit, directly we can use. But what is the data type? The data type of this particular value will be same as the data type of your index. What is the data type of your index? Object. Because the indexer data type is object, if you notice, value also will be of type object. You can see parameter object value. So this is implicitly created. And now you are getting an error. What is the error? Object cannot be assigned to integer. What is it? You require unboxing. Reference types, if you need to convert into value type, you require to go for unboxing. So what to do? Int of value. Typecasting. I am typecasting and assigning. Exactly in the same way, you are required to do it for each and every attribute now. Come on. Else if index is equals to 2, ename is equals to string of value. Else if index is equals to 3, job is equals to, same again, string of value. So I make copy paste 4, 5, 6. What is 6? Location, and this is dname, and this is salary. But salary is not string, it is double. So now by using this, we can even assign values. Now by using this, we can even assign values. How to assign the values? Come here. Right now this code is working. So I want to modify now. What I want to modify? I want to modify the job of the employee, and I want to modify the salary of the employee is equals to 25,000. These two values are modified. To verify, let us reprint. Copy, paste. But to just differentiate, I am adding one more extra line break here. You can watch the code. So these are the original values and these are the new values. What here? Manager 20,000, manager 25,000. Remaining attributes I did not modify. You can modify any value you want, but I have modified only the two things. What are the two things? I modified job, I modified salary. Okay, so this is how we define an indexer. This is the process of defining indexer. So by defining indexer in your class, you are making your class to behave like a virtual array. Okay, so these are the same indexers which are defined in the array class, using which we are accessing the values of an array. So exactly we defined it in our employee class to access the values. But one thing I want to correct, what is it is? Just to make you understand, in the start I said you int index, but not index here, int index, it is parameter, parameter list. What is that array? That can be of any type, that can be of any type, means not only int, it can be string type. What is that string type? String type in the sense, just like you are accessing emp of 0, emp of 1, emp of 2, we can access it as emp of e number, emp of e name, emp of job, like that also we can access. How? In the place of int index, we can specify there string name. String name, anything you can just use. Go back to the employee class. Right now this is int index. In this place I can change it as string name, and with the name I can start accessing the values. To make it understandable, I'll copy the whole code. Okay, I'll copy up to get, set also will do, but first copying up to get, paste it here. And right now if you notice, I'll get an error here. Why I'm getting an error? Already present, again you're defining. So but my intention now is not int index, it is string name means I want to access the values with the help of the name. And what are the logic, you know? If name is equals to e number, copy this. E name, job, salary, D name, location. So like this, I can just write the code with the help of this. Now come here, in the test employee, if you see accessing the values, watch carefully. You can access employee of int index or employee of string name. Both can be used. So in the place of this one, you can write e number to access the value. In the place of 2, e name. 3, job. 4, salary. 5, d name. And 6, location. So I am able to access these values with the help of the index positions like this now. Index positions as well as names also. Two options are there. One, you can access it by using the index. Two, you can access it by using the name. But the big problem what you will face with name is, actually conditional checks are case sensitive in C sharp. Because conditional checks are case sensitive in C sharp, when you are accessing through name, suppose if you give a wrong case, D name is not in proper case now, it is entered in lower case. You see, it is not providing access. Why? Condition checks are case sensitive. So it's a big problem. To overcome this particular problem, what you generally require to do is either convert your value into uppercase and compare with uppercase value, convert into lowercase and compare with lowercase value. Okay. So this name is there. Name refers to user entered thing now. Okay. Because that name will come here. User entered value. This one I am converting into to upper. So now I should make a comparison with uppercase value. So what is the advantage? Even if the user entered in lowercase or proper case, first it converts into uppercase and compares with an uppercase. So what is the advantage is? I'm using in all the places. Name, job, salary, D name, location. So now you come here, you are entering it in lowercase, but still it executes. Why? First, this D name is converted into uppercase and then compared with an uppercase value. So I'm still able to access the value. So this is how you're just going to write the code. Okay, here I convert into uppercase. Not only like uppercase here, if you want, you can convert into lowercase and also write the logic. No matter. You can either convert into uppercase or you can either convert into lowercase. But right now here also get only present, set is not there. Shall we write a set for it? Copy all the code, paste here, set. And this is not returning a value, this has to assign a value now. It's about assigning the value, not return e number. What it should be? E number is equals to int of value. E name is equals to string of value. Job equals to string of value. Salary is equals to double of value. D name equals to again string of value. Location equals to string of value. This is the same code we written in the set accessor with the index value as integer. But right now this code is present here. And I say you can convert into uppercase or you can convert into lowercase. In the place of 2 upper, if you want, you can try 2 lower also, no issues. But if you use 2 lower, you are required to just take the value in a lowercase. See, I'll change all these things. It should be completely lowercase now. E number, e name, job, salary, d name, location. And now if you come and watch here, I'm assigning as emp of 3 here. If I want to assign as emp of job. am I signing in proper case? But still no issues. Why? Internally I convert into lowercase and comparing with a lowercase value. Everything works perfect. So as a developer, while writing your code, you can either convert into uppercase and compare with an uppercase value, or convert into lowercase and compare with a lowercase value. So this is the process how we are going to define indexers in our project. Okay, so when you want to provide access to values of a class to the outside environment, we can define these indexers. We have another option also, property, that's a different story, but these are indexers. Indexers will make our classes to behave like virtual arrays, and you can start accessing the values with the help of the index positions. Okay, index position means it can be an integer value or it can also be a string name also, not a problem. Tomorrow you want to access the values by using ABCD, you can define an indexer with char. Just like string value, you can go with char value. I want to give access to the values as 1.1, 1.2, 1.3, 1.4, means my indexer can be a double value. So right now we take an int index. If you want to take double index and write the logic, what is it? If value is equals to 1.1, return e number. Value is equals to 1.2, return e name. It is your choice, no restriction. It will never tell you indexer should be of int type. Indexer can be of int type, string type, char type, double type, anything. Bool also can be used, but only two values it accommodates, true or false. So that's why we don't use bool. When you have more than two values, then we can just go with. Suppose you want to return if it is a true, active, false, inactive. In such cases, bool can be used, because more than two you cannot do with the help of a bool. But char, string, int, all these things can be used for representing n number of attribute values. Fine. So this is about your indexes. And thank you for watching the video. For more videos, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, Naresh IT.